Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the 12th meeting of the Rural Affairs, Islands and Natural Environment Committee in Session 6. Before we begin, can I remind those committee members using electronic devices to switch them to silent. Our first item of business is consideration of the Plant Health EU Exit Scotland Amendment No. 2, Regulations 2021, and I refer members to Papers 1 and 2. I also welcome Lorna Slater, Minister for Green Skills, Circular Economy and Biodiversity to Committee. It's not the first time we shall meet you, I'm sure, Minister. And with you as your officials, Clorinda Burrell, Rachel Coutts and James Knott joining us remotely. Minister, would you like to make an opening statement?
Thank you, Convener. Thank you very much. Thank you for making the time today to consider draft SSI, the Plant Health EU Exit Scotland Amendment No. 2, Regulations of 2021. The regulations are being made to amend Scottish legislation in the field of plant health, in particular in relation to fees payable to Scottish ministers associated with plant passports and phytosanitary certification for forestry products. Provision is introduced to facilitate an exemption from the requirement to pay fees for phytosanitary certificates for forestry exports from Scotland to Northern Ireland in certain circumstances under the UK Government's Movement Assistance Scheme. This will serve to support Scottish exporters post-transition period. As Northern Ireland remains part of the EU plant health system, exports from Scotland to Northern Ireland are required to fulfil EU entry requirements, including phytosanitary certificates. The Movement Assistance Scheme, funded by the UK Government, temporarily removes the requirement on exporters to pay fees associated with obtaining a phytosanitary certificate for exports of plants and plant products to Northern Ireland. Provision is also introduced to increase the fees charged for export certification services for forestry products and inspections in connection with a plant passport authority for forestry professional operators, reflecting an inflationary rise in the cost of providing these services. Fees for these services have not been increased since 2004 and 2006, respectively. This will allow Scottish ministers to recover more of their plant health costs through fees for services, with the aim of minimising the potential spread of damaging plant pests and diseases and enabling Scotland to continue to meet international plant health requirements and standards. The regulations also correct a minor typographical error in the Plant Health Import Inspection Fees Scotland Regulations of 2014 and make amendments to the Plant Health Official Controls and Miscellaneous Provisions Scotland Regulations of 2019 to deficiency fix EU law to make it operable. I consider that these regulations are therefore necessary and appropriate. My officials and I would be happy to take any questions from the committee.
Thank you, Minister. Do committee members have any questions? Rachel Hamilton.
Good morning. Can I ask if the amendment expires on the 31st of December 2022, what happens after that?
We will need to bring it back again to extend it. So the UK government has agreed to extend the scheme to 2023, and so this SSI will need to be brought again and re-amended.
Okay, I have another question. The consultation was done informally with sector representatives. Who were those sector representatives?
So discussions took place in Scotland with the Scottish Tree Health Advisory Group. This group is the core stakeholder advisory group for tree health matters in Scotland. Its membership includes senior expert representatives from across the tree and forest sector who act to facilitate knowledge exchange between Scottish Government and stakeholders. These discussions indicated that the fee increases outlined in the regulations 3 and 4 were considered necessary and reasonable and would not have any significant negative effect on the forestry sector. It's also worth noting that these increases have already been implemented in other countries within the UK, so we are bringing Scotland into line.
That's helpful. And lastly, the budget exportation certification will be used by the UK government, where does that specifically come from for this? Is it an EU transition fund or?
I don't know the answer to that. Right. Maybe my officials can help me with that one.
Okay, that's fine. That's my question. Thanks.
Are the officials able to answer with the helpless answer? Where in the UK budget this money comes from? Or is that one we'll need to get back to you on?
We're not going to have an answer straight away.
We make a note of that and we'll certainly get back to you on that.
We'll write to the Minister on that. Any further questions? No? Okay, thank you, Minister. We now move to agenda item 2, subordinate legislation, which is consideration of formal consideration of motion S6M02211, and I invite Ms Slater to move the motion.
I move that draft SSI, the Plant Health EU Exit Scotland Amendment No. 2 Regulations of 2021, be approved by this committee.
Does any member wish to debate the motion? No. Is the committee content to recommend approval of this instrument? We are agreed. And finally, is the committee content to delegate authority to me to sign off our report on our deliberations on this affirmative SSI? Very good. Thank you. That completes consideration of the affirmative instrument, and I thank the Minister and our officials for attending today. We'll briefly suspend till item 3.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay, our third item of business today is consideration of a notification from Scottish Ministers for consent to the Ivory Prohibitions, Exemptions, Process and Procedures Regulations 2021, and refer members to paper 3 on page 15. Under the protocol between the Scottish Parliament and the Scottish Government, this consent notification has been categorised as type 1, meaning that the Scottish Parliament agreement is sought before the Scottish Government gives consent to the UK Government making secondary legislation in devolved competence. Does any member have any comments on this consent notification? No. Is the committee content that the provision set out and the notification should be included in the proposed UKSI? Agreed. Thank you. And finally, is the committee content to delegate authority to me to sign off a letter to the Scottish Government informing it of our decision today?
Yes.
Thank you. We are now going to, in a slight change to the agenda, we're now going to move into private session and we'll resume with agenda item 4 at 9:30. We're now going to private session.